Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Tongue to Tummy. This is Shritika and today I'm gonna show you the most traditional Bengali dish, Katla Macher Kalia. So let's get started. Here I have taken 350 grams of fish, which I made around 4 pieces. You can use rui or any other large carp. So for the first thing what I'm gonna do is the marination part. So there goes in 1 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1 teaspoon of chili powder and 1 teaspoon of salt. Now coating the spices very well on both the parts. And we'll set them aside for marination till I prepare for the kalia. In the grinder goes 1 medium sized onion, 6 cloves of garlic, 3 small pieces of ginger and 1 tomato. I will grind them into a smooth paste and keep aside for later use. In an aluminium kadhai, I have added 4 tablespoons of mustard oil. When the oil is enough hot and the oil leaves smoke, add the fish pieces, the skin side down. Fry till crisp and golden brown for 2 minutes each side. Repeat the frying process with the other 2 pieces in the same way as the previous batch. In the same kadhai, adding 3 tablespoons of oil to the leftover oil which I have used for frying the fish pieces. Then goes into 1 bay leaf, 1 dry red chili, 2 cardamoms, 2 cinnamon sticks, 2 cloves and 1 teaspoon cumin seeds. Then goes in 2 medium onions sliced and will fry until barely light brown. It will take around 5 to 6 minutes. Adding the onion, ginger, garlic and tomato paste. Braise this until it darkens in color and the moisture dries up, along with the raw smell goes away. Now goes into the dry spices. Adding 1 teaspoon turmeric powder, 1 teaspoon chili powder, 1 teaspoon jeera powder, 1 teaspoon Kashmiri red chili powder, 1 teaspoon sugar, salt to taste. Stir the spices well until the raw smell of the spices goes away. The oil has already started to separate. Braise again well. Now I am adding the beaten yogurt, stirring very well so that the yogurt does not split. Once everything is well cooked, pouring 2 cups of water, you can also add hot water to it. When the curry becomes up to the boil, gently add the fried fish into the curry. Add handful of raisins. also add the slitted green chilies. Simmer the kaliya until the consistency is like a sauce, but make sure that it should not be too thick. Lastly goes into 1/2 teaspoon of Bengali garam masala powder, followed by 2 tablespoon ghee. Mix properly. This is perfectly done. You can serve the katla macher kaliya with plain boiled rice or pulao. Both kaliya and korma has a strong connection with Mughal cuisine. While kaliya has a thin consistency and is an onion-based gravy, korma is typically dairy-based. Try out this recipe at home and give me your feedback in the comment box. If you have not yet subscribed to my channel, then please hurry up and do press the like, share and subscribe button. Don't forget to press the bell icon to get further notifications. Share my recipes with your friends and family. Till then, happy cooking!